Hello, 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 hello. Welcome to my eyes again. This is Daniele Puleo talking to you from CiboDivino Marketplace to do another live cooking demo with all of you. Thank you for joining in. I'm going to wait a few seconds or maybe a minute or so for everybody to get in there. Maybe camera woman can tell me how many people we have so far. So
six.
I have an idea. Six, okay. It's got to keep growing. Yeah, there is a lot going on behind this camera. You know, camera woman, and there is a lot of people, my dogs. Yeah. Everybody's ready for this cooking demo. So let me tell you real quick about the history of this pasta. Penne alla puttanesca. Puttanesca comes from puttana, which in Italian is the prostitutes. It was created in Naples, in the quartieri spagnoli, which is a very famous area in Naples. And the owner of this whorehouse, basically, was feeding the prostitutes penne alla puttanesca. No, penne made this way, and then it was called puttanesca. So that's where the name comes from. My wife is saying no. So I will tell you a little bit of history of this. So we don't recreate anything, basically. It's another traditional recipe of what the Italian recipes are all about. We do traditions, whatever it is, it is. So having to wait a little bit longer, I hope you had a taste of the wonderful add-on, which is the two prosciutto, prosciutto di San Daniele, prosciutto, no, it's not named after me, and prosciutto di Parma. Great, both for quality, top-notch stuff, and also the wonderful grana padano, which I can eat pounds every day, better not, otherwise my cholesterol would go sky high. And so is my son, that is in Salt Lake City, Utah, which I had to send a big piece because he loves Parmigiano and Grana Padano. He lives on it, basically. Anyway, let's talk about the wines. Tonight, we have this wonderful Barbera Oltrepo Pavese, which is an area in Lombardy, up north, west Italy, made by Casteggio. Great wine. If you did buy it, I'm sure you agree with me, you know, wonderful acidity, great cherry notes, you know, nice consistency, beautiful complexity, and wine that can be, you know, drank by itself or you can go with food such as this.
Giuseppe says enjoying every bit of that Parmigiano.
Oh, I'm sure. I love you, baby, my son. The other one is, I'm sure he probably finished it already. I sent him like a couple of pounds, he's probably done with it. The other one is this wine that I fell in love with. This is a white, always from Lombardy, which is a region, I have to tell you, fairly unknown in the US market for winemaking, but it's amazing. If you only consider the fact that in Lombardy there is the area of Franciacorta, which makes the best, I shouldn't say the best, otherwise somebody else would get upset, but an unbelievable amount of sparkling wines. Franciacorta is very famous to be a biological area, so clean wines, clean juice, method champenoise, so we're talking about the classic method, same way champagne is made. And for many reasons, Franciacorta actually was the big answer for the French champagne. So Lombardy, this one is a great Trebbiano from Lombardia, amazing wine. Oh, I love this song. Duva from Americana. Anyway, great, zesty with a little bit of almond. You know, it's got this bitter almond in the background. Some grapefruits, fantastic, fabulous. I enjoy it every day, every time. Let's go to the ingredients that we're gonna use tonight. So, because I have to feed more people tonight, yes I do, because I feed all the people that here. I have more tomato sauce than you do. So, I'm trying to justify the fact that I have more tomatoes. That's why I have more garlic, that's why I have more capers, more olives, more anchovies. This is completely up to you. I don't know how spicy you like your pasta to be. So you can put less, you can put more, you can put all, you can put black pepper as well. Do whatever you want. A little bit of olive oil. Like I always say in my previous live cooking, Sentami, non c'è sta niente da fare. Ok, Napolita, tu vuoi fare l'America? Cook with olive oil. Find a good olive oil. It doesn't have to be extra virgin. When you cook on the stove, find good olive oil. Then you can always finish with an extra virgin olive oil, which in this case is my beautiful, lovely friend, Christy Evans, that gives me the bum feet, which I love. Anyway, and then you can put it on top of the pasta. I like to use extra virgin olive oil when it's raw, more than cooking it. When I cook it, it's the same oil that I gave you. It's an olive oil. I mean, I'm telling you. Anyway, first things first. So, we have everybody on, or?
We have 25.
Oh, let's go.
The cheese is creamy and delicious. Do you have more for us to buy?
Yes, I do. I do. I don't have much, but I do. I have some. So anyway, let's start the water pot. Okay, I put it on medium. Oh, my stove is stupid. I put it on medium, all right? And I leave it like this. So tonight I'm using, what's up with that? Call the fire department. So tonight I'm using a wok. I'm gonna cook this with a wok. I'm not using my 12 inches, 14 inches saute pan. It's because I wanna show you that if you do have a wok, you can cook Italian food, okay? So that's what I'm gonna use, so you can look at it. Plus, obviously, I'm gonna use more pasta than you have because I have to feed more people. Otherwise, here they're gonna beat me up. I'm gonna start a riot pretty soon. Let's take a short break. And we are back. All right, so let's start doing this thing. So we got the water going. Let's prep everything else. First thing we wanna do, yes.
How should you ask for the cheese?
Oh, you gotta ask for me. Yeah, so is Daniele available? Right now, Daniele is available every day. So come and see me and I'll do it for you. I'll give you a piece because it needs to be cut in a certain way. So now, the recipe calls for all these ingredients. How you use the ingredients is completely up to you. The olives can be chopped, can be halves, can be quarters, can be whole. It's however you want to use it. Obviously, the more you chop the olives, the more oil will come up from the olives, the more flavor you're gonna have. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for flavor, so I'm gonna probably chop them together with the capers, which I'm gonna chop really well, so I get more flavor on it. On the garlic, so we gotta make a decision on this. Me, I like the taste, the flavor, and the aroma of the garlic, but I don't like to chew on it. Now, if you don't mind to chew on the garlic and you want to have that overpowering, then the recipe calls for 1-2 cloves. You can put 100 cloves. As far as I'm concerned, I don't care. You're going to eat the way you want to eat. Me, I'm just going to put the whole garlic and then I'll remove it. Because I just want to give the flavor to the tomato sauce. That's all. Same, like I told you, on the chili flakes. And same on the anchovies. How much anchovies you want to use is totally up to you. You gotta feel that the anchovies is in there, but you don't want to overpower it maybe. Then if you feel like you want to add a lot of, it's like people that like the Caesar salad, but they don't like the anchovies on top. So they can take the anchovies in the dressing, but they cannot take the ones on top. Anyway, so having said that, we're gonna start with getting the garlic and get the garlic inside the pan, I mean the saute pan. So yours is already clean. Mine, I have to clean it up, obviously. So I break it, I leave it whole, like I told you. See, at this point, the garlic oils are coming out and they will come out pretty fast because the garlic is broken. So I don't have pieces, I will remove it. So I'm gonna start my wok over here. I'm gonna put it at medium to medium low. I don't want the garlic to burn. I don't want anything else to happen.
Is that how the anchovy gets added or is it chopped?
No, you can chop it or you can cut it in half because we're gonna liquefy the anchovies into the sauce. Okay. So, oil in.
How do you say wok in Italian?
Wok. Wok. I don't know. So, on garlic and... So, to answer that question, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put the whole anchovies in there. That way, you can see this happen, okay? So, what am I? Medium? I'm a medium. I am on medium. So, be very careful, salt and... let's be careful on salt, because obviously, the anchovies retain a little bit of salt. So, what I'm gonna do here... Yes, my audience is... Look what's happening here. You see what's happening here? So the anchovies are gonna start cooking, and they're gonna liquefy it a little bit at a time. We don't want it to burn, we don't want it to fry. So lower it. There you go. Medium low, yes. Let it go very slowly. As the anchovies go, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna cut my parsley. Your parsley is already chopped. But what I'll do is, I'm gonna remove these babies, okay? And I'm going to throw it in there. Okay? So when you're making this pasta and you wanna use the garlic, remember, put this stuff in here. What do you call this?
Stems.
Put the stems in there. We're going to remove them. Obviously, you're not gonna eat them. We're going to remove them later. But can you smell the anchovies already? They're liquefying. You see what's happening there? All right. So after this, I love it. Can you get a little closer? All right, after this, what we're gonna do is, you see, starting to liquefy. You see, the garlic is not burning. It's cooking, but it's not burning, correct? We got that, yes, okay. Keep going. Now, tomato sauce in. I should say San Marzano tomatoes, crushed San Marzano tomatoes, which are the same tomatoes that we use at CiboDivino for a pizza sauce. It's an incredible sauce. So once it's empty, what I do is I put a little bit of water, okay?
So let's look at that level.
Nothing goes to waste.
A little bit of water.
Yes, nothing goes to waste. Here we go. Okay, let me see if anybody needs me to slow down. Please let me know. So at this point, I really don't want to put any salt, you know, but what I do want to do, and that's a decision that you have to make at this point, is how hard do you want this dish to be? So, if it was for me, that would probably be enough. But knowing my wife, I would probably have to put it off. So,
more.
She asked for more. So, she likes it. She likes pretty spicy. So we're gonna have to let this cook for about 10 minutes, you know, because obviously, being the tomatoes raw, they have to cook. In the meantime, because I always tell you, you know, to make good sauce, it doesn't take that long. Right now, we wanna raise the fire to medium, so we can bring everything to temperature. Yes? And I'm going to show you what I'm gonna do with the capers and with the olives. So I put them together, okay? I get my parsley, which you don't have to do right now because you can add your parsley. Your parsley is already chopped. You can do it later. Me, my parsley is not chopped yet. So I'm gonna chop everything together with olives and with the capers. Now, why am I doing this? Because I want the garlic, I want the parsley to release everything, all the flavors and all the aromatics, so it's gonna go into my sauce. So instead of leaving this whole or halves, because I want this to give the maximum power to my sauce, I'm going to chop it. So when you do it yourself, maybe next time, this is something you want to try, you know, and see the difference, because it's going to be much more flavorful if you do it this way, because it's releasing all the oils in the parsley, in the capers, and in the olives. You will still have the flavor of the pasta. With this, you have more flavor. So at this point, what I'll do is, I'm just gonna add it to my sauce. There we go. I would like somebody to tell me how they like the wines, by the way. Everybody happy with the wines? Yes, yes.
It says, what music are you playing?
Oh, this is like Italian-American stuff, you know? Renato Carosone I played Renato Carosone because Renato Carosone is from Naples, and this recipe is from Naples, so it was perfect to do. You know, the Tu Valle Americano, which is a very famous song, even here.
So this is Big Night's movie. You should tell them about it.
Oh, that's a Big Night movie. This is a movie that came out about, what, I'm aware, 20 years ago? Maybe 25 years ago. It was called Big Night, and it was a movie about these two brothers. They were restaurateurs, they owned a restaurant, and they were trying to do everything right, a little bit like I do, and they were very unsuccessful, a little bit like I am, and but the person across the street that was doing all Italian American food and was doing everything wrong was very successful, just like
it happens
in Dallas. Okay, she said, "Don't say it." I was about to say it, but anyway, sometimes when you try to do things right, it doesn't happen. But anyway, so a very famous movie. When I had my first restaurant here in Dallas, Daniele Osteria, I did. Okay, look at my sauce before I finish. Now is the time for me to lower it a little bit. Okay, and let it go. We're going to adjust of salt and pepper a little bit later. Give me about 5 minutes. We still have time. Your water, I hope your water is about to boil. So I haven't put any salt and pepper. Any salt in the water. Do not put oil, please, in there. So I'm gonna put a little bit of, I will say probably a couple of teaspoon of salt, so it's gonna help the water to boil faster, and then we're gonna add the sauce, the pasta.
Can you use, when you put water, can you use red wine instead?
In what?
You put water in the sauce, no.
Well, you can put red wine if you want to. I mean, this recipe doesn't call for wine, but if you want to put red wine, it's gonna darken the sauce a little bit. If you really want wine, I would probably use white. Red would make the sauce a little darker. But it's totally up to you. Whatever you want to do. Now, water boiling. Is everybody's water boiling? No?
We're waiting.
Pasta.
The red is great.
I'm sorry?
Someone said the red is great.
The red is great? Good.
Yes.
Who is this?
That was Trisha.
Hey,
Wyndham.
Trisha, I'm glad you like it.
And okay. Rob Shearer.
Oh, Rob. Rob was late to pick up his stuff. Rob. That's no good. Okay. Rob's got some of the most beautiful daughters I've ever seen. This guy is locked. He's by himself with four girls, a wife and three girls.
And tell them we're going to the next class. Kids cooking class.
The next class we're going to do, she said, is a kids cooking class. Don't miss that one, especially if you got a lot of girls like Rob. Rob Shearer. All right, my pasta, obviously, I have to put more because I got to feed all these people back here. So the pasta goes in. This one is pasta from Gragnano. Once again, I stick with the model, Gragnano in Campania. You know, where all the winds coming down from the Apennine and all the winds coming down from the sea meat in this very particular place of Italy, in Campania, which is called Gragnano, with the pasta they found out dries better than anywhere else. That's why it's so famous.
So we put all the ingredients in there, including the capers, correct?
Yes, I chopped up the capers with the olives and the parsley.
So Juju was asking for a friend.
A friend? Juju is gonna have to get a friend in Las Vegas. Oh gosh, Juju is the person. We have a pasta in the trattoria that's called gnocchi alla Juju. That's Juju, right there. A very, very good friend of ours. Anyway, so this is going in. Pasta is in. Ready to cook. I think this is enough for everybody. Sauce is going, if you look at it. I'm going to taste it, but something tells me I need a little bit of salt. Okay? And a little bit of more pepper, otherwise Christina will not be satisfied. Huh? And I hope Camera Woman likes pepper too.
I do like pepper.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, Camera Woman likes pepper. So we'll do this. My pasta cooks in 9 minutes. Gragnano, 9 minutes. So what we're gonna do is, well, you know me already, 7-8 minutes, shut it off, let it sit for a while, you got it al dente, very al dente. Look at my wok, look how beautiful this is. I am about to...
Kathleen says hi.
Oh my God, ciao Kathleen! That's another a wonderful friends. I just spoke to Dries today. That's her husband. Via text. So, my cloves of garlic are out. I did everything I had to do with the garlic. This job, it needs to come out. Done. If you like, once again, if you don't mind to chew garlic and you want to do it extra fine or even liquefy it, you can leave it in there. No problem. The extra pieces I can't find the other one.
The stems.
Oh, here it is. Yeah, the stems. Mm-hmm. I can take them out. They did their work too. All right. So where am I left with? Is my pasta, which is going really well. My tomato sauce is going really well. So what I do is, since the gluten is going into the water, my sauce, it looks pretty good, but I'm gonna show you something. If you, Camera Woman, if you look at this, my sauce looks nice and liquid and shiny. By the way, the tomato sauce, the sauce always have to be shiny. So what I'm gonna do, if it dries too much, I help myself with a little bit of pasta water that has gluten. So at the end, when we do the mantecatura, which means that, you know, we saute everything together, we still have that thick kind of sauce. We don't want water left on the dish, never. So this is done too. Any more questions? Is everybody with me so far? I mean, are you at this point? Can everybody tell me if they're at this point? No? Yes? No? Nobody? Nobody has questions. I love you guys. I'll tell you what. Hey, salute to that. I am sure everybody has a glass of vino, including my San Giuseppe. Hey, Peppy, don't drink it too much. So, let's have a toast. So far so good. All right. This is going. Perfect. This is going. I got a couple more minutes. You guys are gonna be good tonight. I'm sure a lot of you already ate the two prosciutto. You know, the San Daniele aged a minimum of 12 months, Parma minimum 18 months. Great prosciutto, both of them. And also the fantastic grana padano that my son is making a killing out of it. Okay, no questions. Nobody, nada.
Someone said my pasta isn't boiling yet.
Hey, the water should boil. My thing is, never put the pasta in the water unless it's boiling. So if your water wasn't boiling, you can wait, no problem. As long as you see the rest of the thing, you can wait. But make sure, if you put the pasta when the water is not boiling, sometimes it sticks. And it's gonna be very hard to split. Especially the penne. The penne have this tendency of splitting.
Chris Hendricks says hi.
Ciao, Chris. Oh my God, see you tomorrow morning, Chris. We walk the dog at the same time. He lives across the street. It's a beautiful neighbors over here. And we walk the dogs at the same time. So, ciao Chris, ciao Dave. I'm sure Dave is here too. All right. Rina, buonasera.
Can you keep doing this when COVID's over?
Time to Napoli. We started without COVID, no? Yes, I'll do this. As long as you want me to do it, I'll do it.
But we need to take requests on what classes they want.
Okay.
What kind of classes would y'all like to see?
Let it rest. Yes, what kind of class would you like to see? The next is for kids. So you have kids, you don't have kids? You know, sometimes, hey, if you don't have kids, you got husbands, right? Those are kids. I call myself a kid too because that one over there is really well. So anyway, boom, done. So you want to be even more accurate? Look, it's a little bit fatter. I'm gonna leave it in there for a couple of minutes. Then it goes into the sauce. In the meantime, what I would like to do. To Napoli, I mean the music with this recipe. I'm going to taste it. What can I say? It's hard to be me. Minka. Ooh. Oops.
I love
I'm sorry.
It for date night.
Oh my
Maybe
God.
You should do a Valentine's so, class.
That's a good idea. I didn't put too much salt over here. Salt over here is perfect. I'm expecting that when the... You know what? Camera woman, you better be ready with this. You see? Yeah, I got spicy. I got the spice girls over here. Oh, God's sake. All right, this is cooking. Now is the time. Directly into the sauce. I don't care if there is water that gets in there. It makes no difference to me. So, boom. Angelina, waitress at the pizzeria.
They wanted a Valentine's Day class.
We'll do it. All right. Valentine's class, we gotta do it with the guests. So we got this, right? Look at that. I'm gonna let this cook for a minute with the sauce. Oh. I adore you. All right, are you at this point right now? Don't worry about the extra liquid. It's gonna be absorbed by the pasta as it finishes the cooking process. I just wanna show you the complete thing. Waitress at the pizzeria. Hey, somebody waving. You see that? Right now, it's finishing. You see, that's why I like the wok, because it's very, you can go even higher if you want to.
This is a splash zone.
No, not a splash.
You didn't get anything on you?
Nope, not a splash.
What? What? Now you're just testing fate.
Not a splash. Once again.
Rob wants you to sing some more.
What? No. I love Louis Prima. Okay. See, that's called mantecatura. Now, this pasta doesn't call for cheese, all right? Now, would it be bad if you put cheese? No, probably not. If you like cheese, you can put cheese. The only thing is the marriage of the cheese with the sardines is a little bit weird. Although, in the Caesar salad, you got cheese and sardine together, but that's on a dressing. It's a little bit different on a pasta, okay? On the salad, it's a little bit more fresh. On a salad, it's different. So if you wanna do it, woo! There you go, not as splash. Well, now it's time for what? Let's see how it is.
This is really...
You see the sauce is reducing with the pasta? Yeah. Pasta is absorbing all the sauce. Wonderful. Looking good! So what I'm gonna do, this is done. Give it like a quick 1 minute boost. And this is very important, actually, if you follow my direction. Is everybody at this point yet? Or? So once I'm here, that's the end, raw. Look, extra virgin olive oil on top, yes? Can I give it a quick twist?
Is it acceptable to add bacon to this?
You can add bacon, but you're gonna do it all the way at the beginning, okay? You gotta have it a little bit crispy if you want to. But at that point, you cannot call it puttanesca anymore. Then at that point, it's very close to an amatriciana with the capers, olives, and now I have to do the test, right? Perfectly al dente, perfect of salt, a little bit on the spicy side, which is okay. If you want to add less spice, it's fine. I can taste the anchovy, like I said, it's the way it should be. The capers and the olives in the background make a great complexity in this pasta. Wonderful with this white or with the red. I hope you are at this stage right now, because recipe is pretty much finished. If you want to drop me a line or send these photographs of your final product, will be great.
What was the name of?
Reply to you.
What was the name of the olive oil?
Oh, Bamfi. I use Bamfi. It's a gift from my good friend.
What they got in the kit?
Oh, it's just I don't remember the name of the olive oil. I'm sorry. It's what we use over at Cibo. Drop me a line. I can tell you tomorrow.
When do you add red pepper?
Red pepper later, after the tomato sauce went in and it starts cooking, then you put the red pepper. You can put the chili flake at the beginning with the oil, but they're gonna toast a little bit, so they're gonna lose a lot of their power right away. I like to put it directly into the sauce so they release the spiciness as the sauce goes along. But I'm telling you, this thing is fantastic. Oh yeah. Oh wow. I mean, it's fabulous. These people are lucky. I love it. Great consistency, perfect pasta, perfectly al dente too, exactly the way I like. Drop me a line, let me know. Tell me what you think about the wines, tell me what you think about the pasta, the recipe. Tell me if I should change something for you, if it's only the music, I guess. Otherwise... What class you want to see? Yeah, let me know. Let me know if you're interested about some Italian dish that you really want to see. Please let me know. Give me the idea and we'll move forward. Otherwise, I'll see you in 2-3 weeks probably with the kids class. Oh, get a lot of potatoes ready. Okay, something tells me that there's gnocchi in this thing, but we'll see. Well, from me, my staff, camera woman, that lady over there, my girls, you know, thank you very much for being part of this evening. Thank you for coming to my house, and thank you for following my live cooking demo so diligently. I love you all. Whatever I can do, let me know. In the meantime, Puttanesca, everyone. Thank you all. Salute.